Web request cancellation is one of the fundamental building blocks of modern internet. It is literally built into the internet. The good news is that ASP.NET Core supports request cancellation natively, and all the libraries under it also support it. So it remains you. It's your responsibility now to implement cancellation in every single web application or web API you design. Now you may come and say, yeah, but our application is very small. We don't have any heavy queries. We will survive a spike or two. No, that is really not how web applications work today. It will be easier if I just show you how it works in code. So please join me in this demo and you will see it all. These are the implementations of endpoints in a minimal API which I have prepared. This operation, for example, queries all entities of one type. You can imagine a query of this kind being really fast. That is totally possible. Let's take a look at the post endpoint, which might be a bit heavy, but still nothing to worry about. It consists of several operations, each is fast. It all ends with a series of small inserts into the database. All endpoints in this web API are really fast in practice. I have no objections to the performance of my application. So why cancellation? It is counterintuitive, and you need to understand this well. Here's the problem. Everything is fast. The system is healthy. There is no delay, no waiting, no queuing anywhere. However, the problems happen. Maybe the underlying database server is in trouble, and your once fast and simple queries start queuing, nothing to worry about yet, but a response that used to be well under 1 second is now 2, 3, 5 seconds, maybe 10 seconds, if it's 10 seconds. A user or two will press reload because they already lost patience there around the 4th second. New requests for the same content you didn't deliver a moment ago will cause the underlying problems to grow larger. And so more and more users will press reload, reload, reload. Also known as the retry storm. The retry storm means that while the request from a user is somewhere in the database connection pool queue, that same user initiates literally the same request again, putting another item into the queue, and then another, destroying any chance for your database to recover soon. Now, when you understand this, you will understand the miracle of request cancellation, and it is very, very easy to implement. Add cancellation token to every endpoint implementation. And remember, we cancel even the smallest SQL requests. The next step is to pass this cancellation token to any database library you're using. The simplest choice for you is EF Core because it supports cancellation. This is the controller action implementation, which does the same thing as that minimal API endpoint. But it uses EF Core, so it will be easier to complete what I wanted to show you. Add the cancellation token. Controllers also support cancellation the same way as minimal API does. And then simply pass it on to every asynchronous operation you invoke using EF Core. Find async supports that. Any async supports cancellation. Save changes async. It is where the database transaction happens. It's very important to cancel that. Don't do anything in the database. Don't save anything if the request was canceled. Here is one action that just queries the database. Add cancellation tokens to queries too. First or default supports cancellation. first async, single async, two list async, all those methods in E, of course, support cancellation. So just pass the token there and you will be done. By the way, if the cancellation has been signaled, then any such request in the database connection pool would be canceled and thrown away. It won't even touch the database. You won't even get the connection to the database. If it got the connection, if it's there already, then the database engine supports cancellation all the way through. It will stop working on the first possible opportunity. So you will definitely save resources if you pass the cancellation token all the way through to libraries that support cancellation. And I said, all the libraries today support cancellation. Let's return to the minimal API, because it uses Dapper. Dapper also supports cancellation, but you will likely have an indirection, a layer of abstractions around Dapper, such as repositories. So your work would be to support cancellation in your abstractions, which you are using to hide the Dapper behind those larger abstractions. I will show you a coding trick now. So watch this, it will be interesting. I will add cancellation tokens to both query actions in this interface, but I am setting the default because I want this to be a non-breaking change at this point of development. I will remove default later when the time comes. You see, the endpoints are compiling. From the point of view of endpoints, this is a non-breaking change. But it is a breaking change from the point of view of the implementers, the concrete repositories. That is where Dapper lives. When I accept the cancellation tokens, I need to pass them to query async, for example. Query async does not accept cancellation token directly, but it does so in the variant which receives the command definition. And there you pass the cancellation token because it is the SQL command that you're canceling. The rest is straightforward. Everything works the same as you have seen here. This is the abstract repository for commands. I will support cancellation in the update async operation, for example. Here is the concrete implementation for one entity type. I don't want to bother you with the details. The point is that you just implement cancellation in depth in each of these methods. Just pass the cancellation token to every call to Dapper and you will be done. But now comes the second part of the story. You want to make sure that you're really canceling all web requests, because that is where the cancellation begins, on the web. Remove all the defaults from all abstractions, get back to the minimal API, and enjoy the view. All calls that end up in Dapper are now red, because I haven't effectively sent the cancellation token to any of those. So what I did was really a coding trick. It is a practice which I often apply. I remove the defaults and let the compiler tell me where I didn't pass an actual object in place of a default, so that I must pay attention to each of those lines of code. Of course, the solution is just to pass the cancellation token to each of them. That's it. In a series of small steps, very safe steps, it's virtually impossible to make a mistake, I have made my application resilient to performance problems on the database server. And remember, those problems will happen. They don't depend on you. It doesn't matter whether your queries are fast or not. The good news is that cancellation, as implemented in ASP.NET Core, is the low-hanging fruit. It takes no time to implement it in the entire web application, and you literally have no place for mistake.